Let's import a SVG image file. Select the SVG import file, and S to scale. G to move, and let's move the mesh's origin to the 3D cursor. Shift D to duplicate, and Enter to settle. I'll use the duplicated mesh to show you how the distortion occurs. When the selected mesh appears to be red, click elsewhere and select the mesh again. Let's convert the curve to mesh. This is how the SVG converted mesh usually looks like. Let's use the curve point bend method to bend this mesh. Please refer to the previous tutorial to learn more about the curve bending method. Looks like we need to rotate the mesh on the Z-axis. Anyway, what I wanted to show you was this distortion issue on the surface. Let's use the simple deform modifier and examine the mesh's surface. It gets worse if we extrude the mesh. There's a way to prevent the surface issue. Let's remove this mesh, and unhide the original SVG import mesh. Let's extract the SVG outline by converting it to mesh, converting it back to curve, and converting it once again to mesh. I found this outline extraction method myself. Let's use this mesh as the knife project source mesh. We need a target mesh, and we can use a grid with 100 cuts. Let's select the source mesh, and type G and Z to move it upward a bit. Let's knife project and see how the mesh would look like. We won't need the source mesh anymore. Do you see how the faces are mostly quads now? Let's bend the mesh and see if we'd see any surface distortion issues. Let's rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the top viewport. That's how we fix the SVG import mesh's surface issues. After solidifying, we need to auto-smooth to fix the normal issues. I'll set up the render scene and use metallic material for the mesh, and add a ground mesh with the noise node added. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned look dev HDRI setting. I'll use the sky texture. Let's turn off. Use nodes, under compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Please like and subscribe, if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.